Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I'm going to be talking about my favorite makeup products for the month of July. I must say, July was an amazing month full of relaxation, and quite honestly, the products that I have for today, there isn't a lot. I was using a lot of my old favorites. So yeah, I mean, that means that these guys really stood out because I have still tried a lot of new products, but these are the ones that kind of rocked my world here. So if you want to see what those products are, then just keep watching. Hi guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I'm a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. And let's start off with my channel of the month. So a channel that I have been loving is All Feisty. Oh my gosh, she is so knowledgeable about products and makeup. She has a lot of experience with makeup as well. And lately, she's been getting a lot of the luxury collections and covering them. I watched her whole review on the Chanel Fall collection, which she was very knowledgeable on. And it was so helpful to me as a viewer, as a person who's getting into Chanel. She got the Dior highlighters. She has the new Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate blushes. She has just been killing it with the content lately. So I've been enjoying the products that she's been reviewing. And what I love about her is she has such a calm air to her. You feel like you're just sitting there hanging out and talking about makeup. So I think you guys would really enjoy her channel. And like I said, I've been loving her content and the products that she's been reviewing lately. Let's get into the products. We are going to start off with Tools, and I've mentioned this in pretty much almost every video since I've gotten it, but I've been loving the Sonia G Lotus brush set. This came out this month. It was very expensive, but definitely has been worth it. I get asked a lot about brushes. There's a lot of amazing brands that I love and recommend to you guys, but as far as what I think is going to last the longest and just are the most sturdy brushes and the most high quality, it has to be Sonia G. And her brush handles on here was the reason that I had to pick up this set, because I am overloaded with brushes. I don't feel the need to add any to my collection, and I didn't intend on it, but then I saw these handles and I was like, I need to have that. Brush handles aside, the shapes of the brushes themselves are fabulous as well. I love this detail brush for highlight. I love this cheek brush for a detailed blush. I am obsessed with the soft definer. It's so nice for my small eyes. Every brush in here is really great, and I've been using all of them in all of my videos, and they are an investment, but I truly believe that these are brushes that you can hand down to your children. They are so good quality, and the shapes are lovely in this set. So I do recommend these. I've been loving these and using them nonstop. I need to wash them again. As you guys know, the Nordstrom anniversary sale has been going on. When it first started, I picked up as much as I could as far as what I was interested in. So if you are interested in a few of the beauty sets, I do have some reviews for you to check out. But the one that has stood out to me a lot is the Charlotte Tilbury Instant Look in a Palette set in Sunset Dreamscape. So this is $75. She's not cheap, but you get the palette and a mini mascara. It really wasn't that great of a value compared to what you can normally get. However, the look in a palette themselves without a sale are a really great value, and I've loved these for summer just to throw on when I'm vacation this month. Didn't use this particular color, but I used another one that I had, and these have quickly become my favorite style of palette. She has multiple colors that I love, and this one, while it isn't super unique, I've been enjoying the color story a lot. I would recommend to see my review, and I kind of tell you what's worth it, what's not. If you already have this, do you still need this? But nonetheless, I really love the colors in here. It truly is a pretty everyday rose look, so I've been grabbing for this. It really is so easy. Unfortunately for today's video, I couldn't do a whole look with it because I have other products to talk about, but I did use the bronzer over a cream bronzer that I already had. But if you do want to see it in action, you want to see the kind of look that you can get, I definitely recommend checking out my video on this. You will love it. It's so pretty. The quality is great. If this is a color story that you're into, I highly recommend it, and it's a great way to try out multiple types of Charlotte Tilbury products at a relatively affordable price for her brand. You have eyeshadows, you have a bronzer, you have two blushes and a highlight, and I love this. I really recommend it. I did recently review the Chanel Fall 2021 collection, and it was an interesting video. There's a lot of struggles in there, but one product that I really have enjoyed is the blush from that collection. It's in the shade Ombre, and it's not going to be for everybody. I can't even swatch it. It doesn't even show up by a swatch, but it's the most unique blush color I have in my collection. I do not have another blush like it. It's a neutral rose. Now, it's more so of a hint of rose. It really isn't a rosy blush, but it's so subtle and it's just different from anything else that I have in my collection, especially since I typically love a really pink, bright, popping blush. This is against what I normally like, but I like how different it is. Now, when it's on the cheek, I find it pulls a little bit rose. When I put it on my eye during the review that I did, it actually pulled a little bit more cool. But if you're looking for a neutral blush, I've really been enjoying this, especially if you're more fair or you're not a big blush lover, you don't like the bright cheek that I like, this is really cool. I love the color of this. I told you guys that this one was gonna be in my monthly favorites, but obsessed, in love with the Dior Forever Couture Luminizers. Now, obviously, we didn't need another highlight in our collection, but I said in my original review, this just seems like a more modern take on the highlight, just as makeup has developed and trends have changed. It's like an updated highlight formula. I picked up three shades. I love all three, and I see so many others loving this product as well for good reason. The shade Pearlescent Glow really surprised me because it's like a glittery, but it's so pretty on the eye and on the cheek, and it's not an obnoxious glitter. It's actually more wearable than you would think. I didn't think I would like it, but I ended up really enjoying it. My favorite, however, of the three that I picked up is Nude Glow. It blends into my skin seamlessly, so if you're around my skin tone, this is going to be the perfect everyday highlight for you. And the one that I'm wearing right now, it is a bit bright for me. I think if you're lighter than myself, you would really like this one, but it just goes with the pink and purple looks that I've been doing lately, is Pink Glow. So that's what I'm wearing right now. It's such a pretty glow. It doesn't emphasize texture. It's not metallic. So how I would say like a modern highlight formula is, it's not metallic, it's glowy, and it blends seamlessly into the skin. Like, you can't see where it starts and when it finishes, and these apply so easily. I've really been enjoying these a lot. I highly recommend these. They have a really great range as well, and some of the colors look so beautiful. I see some people using the deepest shade as a blush. It almost has like a duochrome shift to it. It looks stunning. That is on my list to eventually pick up. I believe it's called Rose Coral. But anyways, Dior killed it with this formula. Hello, okay, so we do have another Dior product here. I'm looking down at my desk right now. Lots of luxury wins this month. Everything in here is luxury. But Dior also came out with a Quint that I love. Now, there was another Quint that I did not like that I tried this month, but this one was the winner. And they have fixed the photos on the website. This is the Quint in Romantic Voyage. If you're into pinky, purpley, mauve-y kind of looks, I think you will really enjoy this one. The quality on this one, spot on. It is really beautiful. Even today when I was creating my look, I really did notice how great the mattes and the deep shades blended. It was just so easy. A true luxury formula. Nothing too pigmented. There's just nothing too intense about the formulation here that makes it look very easy on the eyes, very put together. I love the glitter shade that's added here. This shade, I'm not wearing it today, is stunning. You can get a smoky eye. It really is very versatile as well, but this is what I'm wearing today. I love it just as much as the first time that I tried it. So if you have similar taste and tones as myself, you like those purple shades, I highly recommend this. This is one of my new favorite palettes from Dior. They did an awesome job with this one. I picked this up based on your guys' recommendation, and I must say, you did not steer me wrong. So this was originally from the Tom Ford set that came out with the Nordstrom anniversary sale, and everything in here is also very nice, don't get me wrong. But one of the reasons that I was so extremely excited to pick up this set was because so many of you guys were telling me that this is your favorite eyeliner. This is the Tom Ford eye defining pen, and you were so right. I don't know what it is about this eyeliner, but I get perfect wings in seconds. It is so quick. My wings look great so quickly. It doesn't take too much effort. It's just the way that the brush tip applicator applies the product. It doesn't bend too much. It's not too stiff though, so it has some flexibility, but not too much flexibility. It doesn't give off too much formula, it's not too liquidy. Just right where you place the brush is the exact kind of placement and application of the product that you are gonna get. What's awesome about this pen is there are two different sides. There's the itty bitty little side, which I actually don't use as much as I thought I would. I use the longer side, which is still not too long. I love this. It's the perfect eyeliner pen. So thank you for recommending this to me. You guys were right. Where has this been all my life? I'm going to continue to always have this in my collection. All right, so that actually is it as far as makeup. Like I said, I used a lot of my old favorites this month, so these are what stood out of what launched, but I do have a couple other random products. We're gonna start off with body. I have a shower gel that I've used for a very long time now, but I don't think I've ever talked about it, and I just opened up a fresh bottle, and I was like, ooh, I need to tell my subscribers about this. It is a shower gel from Lush, throwback. Lush used to be very big on YouTube, but I still love Lush. And this is the Rose Jam Shower Gel. The way that this lingers on the skin after you shower is amazing. And the scent, it's like a sweet rose scent. So I don't normally like floral scents. Particularly, I don't really like rose either. But this is like a honey rose. It has that sweetness to it. And it smells so good. And my favorite part is that it lingers on the skin when you come out of the shower. When Jose uses this and he walked in the room, I can tell that he used it and it smells so good. So if you're looking for a good shower gel that's kind of expensive, but I just love the way it lingers on the skin, I definitely recommend this. Last product, they did sponsor a video this month, but I wasn't kidding when I said I've been loving their products. Lily Silk, not being paid for this, just genuinely been loving their silk products. If you have not tried silk scrunchies, you need to. These pull out my hair so much less. I think with my curly hair, it's just so easy for a scrunchie to pull out my hair as it comes out. These are so much more gentle on the hair, and they come with so many different sizes. The options really are endless, so I've been using these in my hair solely. And if you saw that original sponsorship, I talked about that bra. Oh my gosh, the comfiest bra I have ever used. You can get them on Amazon as well, which is a little bit easier than ordering from the direct site. So look into it. You will thank me for that bra. You will thank me for these scrunchies. I also really love the silk pillowcase. They have clothes. Anyways, I just needed to mention it again so you know that I really love the products. They've been game changers in my everyday routine. All right, guys, there we have it. This month's favorites was pretty short and sweet. I liked that. That means I really have been enjoying these products. I have picked these of all the ones that I've tried, of products that I want to come back to. So let me know what you've been loving this month. Is there anything in this video that I made you go, I might need that? Let me know. I love hearing how I influence you. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you aren't subscribed to me already, I would love it if you would consider taking the time to do so, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.